I'm Austin.
And I'm Colin.
And we're here in the beautiful city of Nashville, Tennessee.
We're here to find some of the best handcrafted cocktails and coffees this town has to offer.
That's right.
And today we're in the SoBro neighborhood at one of the trendiest restaurants around. It's called Pinewood Social. And not only do they have cocktails, but they also have a bowling alley.
And guess what we're doing tomorrow? We're going out to Germantown to a place called Steadfast Coffee, where they got a special in-house drink, the coffee soda.
Why don't y'all join us for another round?
Dude, I am so excited.
You know, I don't mean to be rude, Colin, but honestly, you're going down.
You know what? Have you ever seen my form before?
Welcome to Pinewood Social. Pinewood is a third space venue, which means that this is a place for all of your daily needs. Coffee in the morning as well as breakfast. Meet a client for lunch. Grab a cocktail and dinner at the bar. We got a bowling alley. It's a reclaimed bowlerama from Indianapolis. 2 4-foot swimming pools outside, bocce ball court, anything you need really. But it looks like you guys are ready to bowl. So go ahead and enjoy your game. Meet me at the bar for a cocktail afterwards.
Now it's important, Colin, when you bowl, if you make a good shot, you always have to celebrate in style.
Well, that's good because I'm a dancer. Let me show you how it's done. Now, Austin, unlike golf, the person with the highest score wins.
You are one of my good friends, but I'm not gonna spare you today. What a game. I could use a cocktail.
Yeah, bowling sure does make you thirsty.
What's happening, guys? Who won the bowling match?
You know, it was a close one, but I definitely won.
Fair enough. Well, let's get you a beverage. What do you have in mind?
I don't know, man. I think I'm in the mood for something whiskey-related, but I'm always open to suggestions. What do you have on the menu?
We've got a whiskey smash. It's a barrel-selected cocktail. It's a single barrel from Chattanooga Distillery. A couple of the guys from the company went out, hand-selected a barrel, and we built a whiskey smash around it.
Now, Chris, is this fresh-picked mint?
It is, yeah, fresh-picked every day.
Oh, Colin, there's nothing I love better in my drink than fresh-picked mint. I am pumped.
How is it?
That is amazing. It takes you on a journey, Colin.
Yeah?
It starts off with a little bit of, like, a pow factor, but that maintains throughout the drink as it serves your palate different flavors.
I'm genuinely pleased with this. That's a great choice, Austin. I'm looking for something a little bit sweeter.
We have the Annexation of Puerto Rico. It's a rum drink. It's a riff on a Mai Tai.
Is this a flower?
It is a flower, and it's edible.
Is that from Puerto Rico?
It's not, no.
I'm gonna give this a try. The flavor's still going. It lasted about 10 seconds, and for a minute there, I almost blacked out from flavor overload. Even though this might be considered a fruity drink, it is amazing. I love it.
I'm glad you enjoyed it, man. Cheers, guys. By the way, guys, somebody dropped this off for you earlier, told me to pass it along to you.
Hey, Austin and Colin. We're sending you to the annual Science of Beer event at the Nashville Adventure Science Center to learn everything about the beer making process and more. Strap on your goggles and get ready to sample some of Middle Tennessee's best local beers. Sincerely, the producers.
You ready for this? I'm excited.
I'm here to learn about this delicious beverage. I've had it many a times in my, well, no, just once.
Well, I'm not much of a beer person at all, so I'm learning how to appreciate it.
We have all learned a lot. Even though I look like I may be a smart guy, I've learned more than I've taught. I can really tell that this was cast in a, was it in a rum barrel?
It's in a rum cask. A cask is a barrel. Oh, look at those.
What is a cask? Is it a barrel?
Yes. It is. It's just sealed.
Today we learned that a cask is a barrel. It's just sealed. And this is a great beer.
We're doing a lot of cool things with smoking with beer. We're doing stuff with molecular gastronomy. We're doing some cold oil spherification. Wow. We're creating beer caviar.
So this time of year we did a Russian Imperial Stout.
Oh my.
We just kegged that last night.
Is that street legal? Besides the beer here, have you done any of the activities?
Well, we just left the planetarium with the Jeopardy going and the bar tricks.
Where are they located?
Right there.
I'd say tonight was a huge success. Mm-hmm. The drinks were awesome, the food was incredible. I couldn't have asked for more.
But I tell you what, I'm getting pretty tired. I'm gonna go take a nap, and let's meet up tomorrow at a pretty cool coffee shop called Steadfast. We we've been open for about a year and a half. The main thing that we like to do here is to take all the basic elements of what make a really great coffee company. So we source and roast our own coffee to the best of our abilities. And then we try and take it a step further and just see what else there is that we can do with that. One of those things is a great food program as well. Just trying to hit all the basic needs that people have when they come into a coffee shop. I want you all to have a seat and get you some drinks. One of the things we have is a coffee soda.
Wait, so coffee and soda?
No, it's actually a soda made out of coffee, which is a little different experience than a lot of people have had with coffee. We brew the coffee and then we actually carbonate that whole thing and serve it with an orange peel, so it's nice and refreshing.
Sounds like an adventure for my mouth.
Yeah, I don't know about you, Colin, but I'll have one of those.
Sounds good.
We'll take a round of the coffee sodas. I'm not sure what I was expecting, but that is incredible. This is a full-bodied experience. You get the carbonation that hits you from the start, then you get the coffee and then a fruity flair on the edge. I could drink these all day. Nathan, I love this first drink, but you have to have something else up your sleeve for us.
Oh yeah. So this is the Atlas, and it's kind of a study in contrast. This drink is a hot drink with a cold cream on top, so you'll get that nice cold experience right up front, and then the hot coffee right underneath. So it'll be a little bit more comforting.
Good deal. I didn't know what to expect with this. It kind of tricks your brain because it starts off decently cold and then the warmth of the coffee comes in and they both mix together to make an amazing drink.
The difference between these two drinks is absolutely incredible, but one thing is consistent through both.
What's that?
The passion that Nathan put into creating these pieces of art and the taste we get are both phenomenal.
It's not just drinking coffee, it's having an experience and meeting awesome people.
Let's talk about meeting awesome people. We went to Pinewood Social, we bowled, we got cocktails, then made our way over to the Adventure Science Center for the Science of Beer. We don't even have words to say how amazing that was. And now we're here. What a fantastic 24 hours it's been, my friend.
That's right. Let's go find a place where we can get another round.
Yeah, man, I mean, I have a theory that this next place is gonna be pretty fantastic.
Subscribe to the Opry YouTube channel to watch new episodes being released each week. Thanks for watching.